two cultures that I'm actually celebrating are the two places where it can't be seen, which is, you know, that kind of works into the theme of the film, right? Like, things will change. They just will change, right? But it is ironic. So it's been in a lot of Iranian film festivals all around the world, right? But no, it has not been to Iran.
Well, first of all, I want to say congratulations. I thought it was beautiful. Just gorgeous looking. But will you talk a little more about the casting? So you got Sandra Oh, Ellen Page, and, you know, the other people that are in the movie. Can you talk a little more about the casting?
Yeah,
how these people got involved?
Yeah, well, Sandra and I have known each other for a long time. We were supposed to make a film 20 years ago, and it didn't come through, a live-action film. And she ended up coming down to the States and becoming Sandra Oh, and I landed up going into a little writer's hut in Germany and writing this film. And
you were saying there are a lot of Dietmars that you met.
Yeah, like everybody knows a Dietmar. And but so I contacted her, and she's always too busy. I asked her if she had a couple of hours just to read, you know, Rosie. And she said, oh, no problem, no problem. And she was actually at the Toronto Film Festival time. She was, oh, well, I was just actually having a massage in a Korean spa, and I was thinking of you. So, yes, right? And I said, you know, you should read it. You know, I turned the storyboard into a graphic novel. I said, you should read it first. And she goes, no, I don't have to read it. I'll just do it. I'd love to work with you. And I said, no, you should read it. And it took her about 3 weeks of me badgering her. And then she called me up, and she was just in tears. For some reason, it really touched her. It just really touched something personal in her life. And she came on and became the spokesperson for it, for the crowdfunding campaign we did, the Indiegogo campaign. So,
how many countries?
Lots. But the best thing about it, because we didn't raise, like, nearly as much money as we thought we could, but because everybody was so excited about Sandra having just left Grey's Anatomy, everybody wanted to hear what she had to say. And so we got incredible, like, page-long press everywhere, talking about, you know, pro-art, pro-girls, diversity, culture, tolerance, like, all of these issues. That was the article, right? It was just her, sometimes me, but mainly her.
And 28 countries, by the way.
Thank you. In 28 countries, yeah, it was just incredible, right? You know, like the Washington Post, a page, Sandra Oh, talking about peace, love, and understanding. It was amazing.
So she helped you get these other people that are in?
Yeah, they're all true connections. The only one, if you'll bear with me, so, like, Shore Agashlu, whose voice I've had in my head for so many years, I tried to approach her before, you know, but it was good. But everybody wanted to come and work with Sandra. So Ellen came in for a couple of hours, you know, they knew each other, and then Amin Tahi and Naveed Negaban, like, she knew them, blah, blah, blah. And then I said, I really think that Nancy Kwan would be good for this. And she said, oh, I don't know how to get a hold of Nancy. And I said, well, she's got, for me, the perfect voice, because she represents this particular time, particular Hong Kong, particular voice, right? And Sam said, well, I can't help you. And so I said, well, I think that my aunt has a connection somehow. My aunt lives in Hawaii. And so I emailed her, and she said, oh, yeah, Nancy's coming over for dinner tonight. And it turned out that she had just been asked to the Hawaii Film Festival, and my aunt's always getting, like, these... She's like an arch, you know, blah, blah, blah. And so I said, well, can you address this to Nancy? Actually, I was just at Nancy's house just now. She just drove me to this theater. So it's like such a crazy story. So Nancy said, yes, of course I would. You know, sure, I'll do it. And then I called my mom in England. I said, oh, my God, Nancy Kwan's going to be in the film. Because for those of you who don't know who she was, like, she broke the race barrier in Hollywood with the World of Susie Wong. Like, some Asian people are not so thrilled with it, because, of course, she's raised a prostitute. But she was, and she's, you know, Eurasian, but she was the first non-white person to have a starring role in a Hollywood film. And then she had, you know, quite a few others, but that was sort of her big claim to fame. So anyway, I told my mom, and she goes, oh, yeah, your grandmother looked after her during the war. And so I wrote to Nancy, because all of this is just email. I rarely talk to people. And so she sent me this picture. picture of her as a baby and her brother sitting on the lawn with my mother and brother and sister that my grandmother had taken. And it turns out that her dad, her mother had abandoned the family, and her dad, her Chinese dad, was a spy who knew my grandfather and had left the kids with my family during the war to be looked after before he took them away. And, like, I mean, that was just so amazing. It was so amazing, right? And she's also playing a character that's based very much on my grandmother, right? And, like, that is how this film has been, right? Mm-hmm. These crazy, crazy connections. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's quite something. And so
that alone could be the basis of another film. Right?
It's just amazing, right? Mm-hmm. And so it took me so long to make this film, but I guess it needed that time to be able to make these kinds of, you know, kinds of connections. And, like, the guy that played DD, a lot, you know, except for the really famous people that just came on.
Yeah.
I did all of my casting on the phone, right? So I just would listen to people's voices. And the guy that ended up playing Didi, his English is very minimal,
uh-huh.
right? But I just liked something about his tone. And then after we recorded, he said, I was at Tiananmen Square.
Right?
He was there, right? Mm-hmm. And we hadn't discussed that at all. And what are the chances of that, right? And Naveed Negaban, you know, like, he was telling these stories that were his stories, you know, and it was just like, how do you know these stories? So it was really, it was an amazing world that opened up, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So...